Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we will see estimation of error. We know the elimination of error completely it's not possible, but definitely we can minimize it. So there are some steps involved for finding the error, for minimizing the error, or we can say estimation of error. So let us start with the steps involved for estimation of error. To understand the concept of estimation of error, we will take one simple example. Now, example is the diameter of rod measured as 1.323 cm, 1.324 cm and 1.322 cm. Calculate average corrected reading, average absolute error, percentage error in measuring the diameter of rod. And if zero error of micrometer is plus 0.02 cm. Now we have taken one simple example. Let us see how to solve this and how to find the error. Now, first thing which is very important here is we have a zero error. Given quantity is zero error, which is denoted by Z. The value of zero error is given, that is plus 0.002 cm. Now, very important point is here, if zero error is positive, in this equation, in this case, we have a positive value, then our measurement is negative. Our measurement or corrected reading is negative. And if zero error is negative, then our corrected reading is positive. Very important point here is, if zero error is positive, then our measurement or corrected reading is negative. And if zero error is negative, then our corrected reading is positive, which plays very important role in the estimation of error. So let us start with the given values. Our given values are, there are three diameters are given. Let's say diameter number 1 is x1, which is 1.323 cm. The second given diameter is x2, that is 1.324 cm. And third diameter is 1.322 cm. And error, zero error is given, that is Z, which is plus 0.002 cm. So first step involved here is finding corrected reading. So first step we will take, that is corrected reading. Now, how to find corrected reading? Here we have a given value, that is corrected reading we will write down XC1. This is the first corrected reading. So XC1 is equal to given value of X1 minus Z. Why minus Z? Because zero error is positive. That's why corrected reading will be negative. So here we have to take minus Z. So 1.323 minus 0.002. You will get one answer here, that will be 1.321 cm. Now second corrected reading, x2 minus z, which is equal to 1.324 minus 0.002, which is equal to 1 minus 3 to 2 centimeter. Third one, x3 minus z equal to 1.322 minus 0.002, which is equal to 1.320 centimeter. Now we have to take average corrected reading. In our question, it is given, that is average corrected reading. It is same as that of average of any number. So for average, we add up all numbers. Divide by 3 here. So here we have a final average reading, that is we can say mean average. So we will write here XM. So this will become 1.321 centimeter. So this is our first answer. After that we have to start absolute error. So let's start with absolute error. Absolute error is the difference between corrected reading and mean average reading. Just now we have calculated what is corrected reading. Corrected reading actually is given reading minus the zero error of the instrument. So here we have a corrected reading and mean average reading, it's the average of that corrected reading. So here we have already calculated this, so we are just putting values here. 1.321 minus our mean average reading, that is 1.321. This mean average reading will be common everywhere, and our corrected reading we will get, this is from x minus z. This is our corrected reading. Now in this way we will get these values. Finally, we have to take average absolute error. Average absolute error means sum divided by this number, total number. So finally, we are getting here average absolute error. The next step to find relative error. Here, relative error is average absolute error upon mean average error. Means relative error is a ratio of average absolute error to mean average error. So here we have to consider average absolute error. Its value is delta x average upon xm, which is equal to 0.00066 upon xm value. This is our xm values. So here we have 1.321. So finally here we are getting 0.0049 centimeter. The next and last step is finding percentage error. We have to express this relative error in terms of percentage. So here we have relative error into 100. In this way we can convert it into percentage. So value of our relative error is 0.00049 into 100. Hence we have here 0.0. This two digit will come forward, so this will become 49%. So in this way we can find out the percentage error, and these are the steps to find or to calculate estimation in error. Thanks for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and please subscribe Ikeda. Thank you so much.